Hare Krishna. So, welcome again to another Maha Mantra melody. Very simple melody actually, so it should be pretty easy for you to grasp. So without further ado, we shouldn't waste any time, let's get into it. As simple as possible the chords for a beautiful melody, which was originally done by Krishna. us. We are only, although it may seem a little confusing, we're only using three chords in this entire melody. So the first chord is here. This is the root position of this chord is actually here, which is F sharp minor. This is F sharp, but we're going to use an inversion to it. So we're just bringing this note down one. So you're actually using the keys to it are actually C sharp, F sharp, and A. You have your little finger on A. So you have C sharp, F sharp, and A. So it's actually the F sharp minor chord, but it's inverted. So instead of using this key here, you bring it down one. So here. Okay, so that's the first chord, which is F sharp minor. Show you the keys again. It's C sharp on the thumb, F sharp on the index finger, and it's A with your little finger. I think this, I've worked out this as the best fingering for this chord. So it's all up to you, whatever you're comfortable with. The second chord, you're coming down here. The root of this chord is actually here, but again this is an inversion. This is actually an E major chord. So you have E, you have G sharp, and you have B, but we're bringing it down one here. So instead of using this B here, we use this B here. So you have B here with your thumb. Start off here. Exactly when we have to change the chords and so on. You get the timing of when the chords need to be changed. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare change the chords, and the slightly higher part is using also the same exact chords, but maybe in the beginning you saw me use the root
continue to use the same exact three chords here. But if you want to get a slightly higher pitch, you can also come to the root chords here. I'll show you with the higher chord. Let me go over the chords with you. It's F sharp minor. It's the same F sharp minor that we used before. Then we go to E major. So you're using your thumb on E, your index finger on G sharp, and your little finger on B. Coming down to D major. So this was E major coming down. You're just shifting your same three fingers down a half note. One chord, sorry. So you just bring it down. It's a transition from right here, from E major to D major. So now you have D on thumb, F sharp on index, and A. Is yours. If you want to continue using the same inverted chords from before and do the high part with the same chords, you can do that. But if you want to get a little higher effect, you can bring it up a little bit. It's all up to you, however you're comfortable. If it's a little too much for you to memorize the two different chords, you can continue to use these same chords throughout the whole melody. If not, gives it a better effect when you go up higher to use a higher chord. And the third part of the melody is you're using the same chords, but the timing is to change it is different. Methods I can come up with to play this melody just using three chords, but it sounds very nice. It blends very nice with the melody, so I think that should be extremely simple for you to pick up. So I do hope you learn it very quickly and enjoy leading your kirtans. Enjoy.